They use words like parasites, describe them as barbaric, even liken them to rats. And could some who talk this way about Muslims also have their say over who gets into number 10? For the last few months, ITV News has been compiling a dossier of Islamophobic comments made by people who say they're Conservative Party members. Dozens of new cases we've seen now take the total to 181, some of whom we've learned are still eligible to choose the next Prime Minister.
Having received this dossier from ITV, it's just, again, shocking and disturbing. Everybody should be suspended pending an investigation. But if you're not suspended, you are entitled to vote. And this is really disturbing because it should not be.
Among fresh comments we've seen, one alleged member posted, "Muslims are an evil ideology who will never integrate and are unfit and unwilling to be part of a civilised society." Another said the Berlin Wall should be rebuilt to keep the Muzrats walled up and out of Europe. A third said Islam is an evil death cult that's invaded these shores and it's your God-given right to fight it. But the Conservative chairman told us comments like that don't necessarily disqualify members from voting in the leadership contest.
If they are being investigated, then in this country we have a very clear process and a long-standing tradition of you are innocent until proven guilty. So if somebody is a full paid-up member of the party, they have voting rights. But if somebody is suspended from the party, and in the cases we have, we act very, very quickly. If somebody is suspended, they do not have voting rights.
So it's possible for someone who's posted Islamophobic comments, for example on Facebook, to vote in this leadership contest?
Well, if somebody has posted Islamophobic comments and is found to have done that, we act swiftly and we would not accept them as a member of the party.
But some of them are just being investigated, they're not being suspended.
Well, you wouldn't know that, Paul, because let's get the difference between the facts and some of the myth that's out there. A lot of the cases that people are saying have been referred to the party, when we've looked into them, are not members of the Conservative Party.
But we've seen emails sent to several members in our dossier. While some were told their membership has been suspended, meaning they can't vote, others were told their behaviour will be investigated, meaning that they still can.
Mr. Potts, could we ask you a few questions about your Twitter, please?
And then there are those who've been allowed to return. This councillor shared posts saying Muslims should be deported. After being suspended, he was let back in.
I don't know who you are, where you've come from.
He has apologised and been on diversity training, but refused our request for an interview.
So we just want to ask you a few questions about them.
I've said to your Paul Brand, and I think it was another two people from ITV, that I shall not be making any comment whatsoever. So thank you for coming, but goodbye.
Right. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
The leadership candidates are also accused of dodging the question. Boris Johnson out meeting officers today, but less willing to police his own party.
Why are you so afraid to have a specific inquiry into this problem?
We're not, and I want you to know, Paul, that we treat all allegations of prejudice or discrimination or Islamophobia within our party, any kind of prejudice, we treat as absolutely unacceptable.
But will you have a specific inquiry into Islamophobia? A specific inquiry?
We will have an inquiry into every manner of prejudice within the Conservative Party.
Hey, morning.
His opponent is more enthusiastic, but still hung up on the definition of any inquiry.
It is a good thing for us to have an external independent inquiry just to make sure that we in the Conservative Party are doing everything we can to root out Islamophobia. But the first step is you have to define what Islamophobia is.
So it's one thing to question the candidates for number 10, but what about the views of those who may send them there?